knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
In the last tutorial, we saw how to solve separable differential equations, but not all DEs are separable. Another important class of DEs are linear differential equations, and in this tutorial, we'll focus on the case where the order of the DE is equal to 1. A linear first-order equation has the general form dy dx plus p of x times y equals q of x, where p and q are functions of the independent variable x. How can we solve something like this? Over the centuries, mathematicians have come up with all kinds of clever tricks for solving different types of differential equations, and this one is no exception. We will introduce something called an integrating factor, called I of x, defined as the exponential of the integral of p of x. Don't worry if this seems completely random, because right now it kind of is, but we will soon see that this integrating factor is our ticket to solving any linear first-order differential equation. Let's take our general form and multiply both sides by the integrating factor that we've just defined. If you stare at this big mess for long enough, you might just notice that the left side of this equation looks a bit like the product rule from differential calculus. If we let our integrating factor be f, and our dependent variable be g, then it turns out that the product rule will give the derivative of the product f times g as exactly this expression. We can therefore replace it all with this derivative of our product, integrate both sides with respect to x, and replace that integrating factor with the symbol I of x to get a tidy formula. When we want to solve a linear differential equation, we don't need to go through all that algebra again. We can just write down the integrating factor and then jump straight to this result. Iy equals integral of iq. Let's see how with an example. Suppose we have a differential equation dy dx plus y over x equals 3x. This dE isn't separable, but it is linear, because we can write it in the standard form, with p of x equal to 1 over x and q of x equal to 3x. Step 1 is to write down the integrating factor, which is I of x equals e to the power of the integral of p of x dx. Here, the integral we need to find is the integral of 1 over x dx, which is the natural logarithm of x. When we're finding integrating factors, we do not need to put a plus c like we usually do. We can just write down the antiderivative on its own. The e and the ln cancel, leaving us with just x for our integrating factor. We can now use the formula iy equals the integral of iq. We get x times y equals the integral of 3x squared dx. Evaluating the integral using the power rule gives us x cubed plus c, which leads to our general solution. If we were given boundary conditions, we would put them in now to find the value of c, but this time we aren't given any, so let's just rearrange for y to get our explicit general solution, which is y equals x squared plus c over x. Now that we know the whole process for solving linear first-order differential equations, let's check comprehension.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.